Let's take a look at elasticity here and the slope, in other words, the flatness or the steepness of a demand curve. First, let's remind ourselves of the definition of elasticity. So price elasticity of demand is the percentage change in the quantity demanded, all that divided by the percentage change in the price of the product. So let's graph two demand curves, and we're going to find out which one of those two demand curves, one with a higher slope and one with a lower slope, which one of those two demand curves has the highest price elasticity of demand. So first we'll graph a demand curve that is relatively steep. So here's a demand curve that is pretty steep. We'll call that demand curve 1. Now let's graph a demand curve that is relatively flat. So this we'll call this demand curve number 2. Now let's take a look to see what would happen if the price of the product decreases. We'll start out at $8 and then we'll make it go down to, let's say, $7. At $8, this is what the quantity demanded is for both curves, D1 and D2. Now let's go to $7, price decreases from 8 to 7. If we go to demand 1, we notice that the quantity has increased a little bit, so maybe the quantity here is, let's say, 20, and it goes to 22. So we can see that there has been a small increase in the quantity demanded from 20 to 22, which means, in terms of price elasticity of demand, that the numerator, this part here, is relatively small compared to the percentage change in the price. So this means that this ratio is relatively small, and it means that the price elasticity of demand is relatively small. Now, if we compare that to the change in the quantity demanded for demand 2, so if we go to D2 at the same price of $7, we notice that at $7, the quantity demanded for D2, well, is probably somewhere around 45 or so. That's a huge increase in quantity demanded. So that means that for D2, this top part of the ratio, the percentage change in quantity demanded, is much bigger than the percentage change in the price. So D2 has a very high price elasticity of demand. And in general, we can conclude that the flatter the curve, for example D2, the higher the price elasticity of demand, and the steeper the curve, D1, the lower the price elasticity of demand. An extreme case is if the demand curve is completely vertical, so very steep, in which case the price elasticity of demand is equal to 0. This demand curve has a perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand. The other extreme is the perfectly elastic demand curve. That's supposed to be horizontal, completely flat. And that is where the price elasticity of demand is super large. It's infinitely large.